Leanne Saunders grew up on a cow-calf operation in southern Colorado, studied agriculture, and worked for food companies. A key takeaway from her years in ag and food.
I think the consumer, as they become farther removed from production agriculture and how their food gets to their table, they've wanted to know more about where their food comes from.
Now, Leanne and her husband run Where Food Comes From, a food verification company based in Castle Rock.
We started off really focusing on animal identification and traceability in the beef industry, but we evolved over time to verify and certify different attributes in the food supply chain, say like natural claims or organic claims or food claims to meet specific export market requirements. So our customers span from everything from a cattle rancher or a farmer all the way to what I would call CPGs or brands that are wanting to verify and certify certain claims on their food products.
Where Food Comes From and its customers rely on cloud-based software paired with devices like RFID tags and scanners for their customers' cattle. The end result? Consumers pay a premium for their product because of traceable and verifiable attributes. But here's what's changed over the years.
10 years ago, it was mostly niche markets. And today, you see big initiatives by companies like Walmart that are looking to make sure that the metrics they have around, say, sustainability, greenhouse gas emission goals, animal welfare goals that they've established, they've moved into having initiatives around wanting to make sure that they have traceable product that meets these metrics. So it's a Walmart shopper to the Whole Foods shopper today.
Chris Kraft, owner of Quail Ridge Dairy, agrees with the popularity of this consumer demand.
People are very curious about where their food comes from, how it gets there, how does it get produced, how are the animals treated. I believe it's getting more and more intense. They want to know more.
Like Leanne, Chris is no stranger to technology and traceability. His daughter Jordan, now head of Ag Innovation and Partnerships at CSU Spur, saw firsthand what tech on the farm did for her family.
My parents are really busy people. They were raising a family at the same time that they were building a business. Adopting technology gave them a lot more time actually to spend with my brother and I is one reason, but it also allowed them to scale.
Chris runs a high-tech operation with data about every one of his 4,700 cows, their vaccinations, milking times, when they were bred and gave birth, and much more on his phone. Like Where Food Comes From, it's all done through RFID tags that are scanned multiple times a day. There's no room for error.
So the milk industry is really highly regulated because we produce a food grade product on a farm, where in a lot of the other industries, the animals are going off-site to be processed.
I always say the safest thing you can put in your mouth in America is milk, because every single drop of it has been tested.
From the RFID tags to the QR codes on tanks and trucks, milk and its attributes are traced because of regulation, but also for price.
And the other reason that the milk truck driver takes the sample is to check what the components in the milk are, meaning butterfat, protein, etc., because that's how we get paid as a dairy farmer.
Quail Ridge Dairy and Where Food Comes From have embraced technology. Neither business uses blockchain-based software, at least not yet.
We are always staying on top of whatever the next technology is that helps our customers. So as blockchains evolved, we've continued to stay abreast of it.
Jacqueline Wilson of Wilson Flying Diamond Beef also sees the trend of consumers wanting more information and paying for it.
Where the extra premium comes in along the chain is definitely from the consumer that wants to know exactly where their product comes from.
Her ranch participated in a project using blockchain technology to trace and verify attributes of her cattle.
That was the best part about the program is that, you know, we were able to say to the consumer, okay, we raised this product. This is what we've done along the way. This is how we can verify it. And this is how we can get it to your plate. And in turn, yes, we asked for a premium for it. But I think there is a number of individuals out there that really respected what we were attempting to do. They wanted that verification and we were able to provide it.
In the next video, we'll see how that program worked and hear Jacqueline's take on the future of blockchain in the cattle business.